if you've ever done any abstract painting, it's not easy. Now this, I was standing in the National Gallery of Victoria a couple of years ago in front of number 52 by Marcus Rothko. Fantastic painting, but you have to stand right back from it. And it shimmers. It's rich and deep and layered and textured piece of redness. Okay? And I'm standing there, loving standing in front of this painting. And a couple of people walked up in front of me. Quite oblivious to the fact that I was actually looking at the painting, that they just walked up in front of me. And I walked up in front of me and they went, "It's red." Turned, moved off. So this painting, again, I just wanted you to stop and have a look at this. You know, we leave the mystical garden and we come to the sacred river. It's an abstraction with really strong, expressive elements. Really strong, expressive elements. And here, the artist captures experience and feeling and moment as much as they capture any formative image. And so for me, this was just, this is a really, really powerful painting. You could hang that in your dining room or in your living room, and every time you look at it, it will give you something different. It's only 1,200. But it is also really competently executed. This is a beautiful painting. And do you know, I came in and landed in Australia on Saturday night. Sunday I came in, did a quick wander through, and I just picked all the paintings that really connected with me. So this is about as honest an evaluation of the art as you're going to get, because I just came in and I just, you know, if it grabbed me, really reached out and grabbed me, I'm going to talk about it tonight. There are a couple that did, but I've, you know, like Jen Pryor always grabs me. But I always talk a lot about Jen Pryor, so I might not talk about Jen Pryor too much tonight. But you know, this is one of those paintings that we're going to put it down.